like you to report it, because the devil has come to rob, to steal, and to destroy. And he has come to take away your lives. And most of us never even realized it until it was too late, and we've already gotten contracted AIDS, we've already lost our virginity, we've already been drunk and puking up our guts, and then we realized, wow, this wasn't fun after all. Jesus has come to save us from ourselves. It's not animals that make nuclear warfare. It's us that we're bent on destroying ourselves. What other mammals would try to destroy themselves? We have enough nuclear that we can destroy the world, I don't know how many times, hundreds of times over. Why do we do this? Why are we so bent on destroying ourselves? Because we are made in the image of God. We are eternal. We do not just die and go in the ground. We just don't get reincarnated into a cow or an animal. We will live forever because we are made in the image of God. And many of us think, well, I sure don't look like God. But on the inside, you have a spirit. You are body, soul, and spirit. You are more than a body, and one of these days, your bodies are going to get old. You're going to be all decrepit, impotent, whatever. You will get old. You will die. That is a promise. Every one of us will die and face the judgment. It's a promise. What can we do to be ready to meet God? It is the best life. Jesus said, I have come to give life and give life abundantly. I mean living. Here is the devil. He wants to destroy you, wants to rob your life. He says, okay, you pretty little thing, try this cigarette, drugs, whatever it is, try this. See if it makes you feel better. Look real cool. Ooh, oh yeah, I look real cool. I'm hot, I'm cool, I like this. Then all of a sudden, you start coughing because you're choking from the cigarette smoke. You know, doctors first prescribed cigarettes.
How was it doing?
Back, actually it was before my day, believe it or not, and they prescribed cigarettes for asthma. That's the medical profession. Not all doctors know everything. So they prescribed these cigarettes. The devil says, here, take this. This will look cool. Smoking pot, smoking cigarettes, whatever you're doing. You're cool, you're fitting in with your friends. All of a sudden you start coughing. You're losing your health. The devil says, hey, wait a minute. I also want your money. Give me your money. You gotta pay for this cancer. You gotta pay for this mental imbalance you get from drugs. You get your rotten teeth from meth and rotten teeth from all the drugs. You gotta pay for it now. So you're paying for it financially. Emotionally, and your health is gone. That is the devil. He comes to rob, to steal, and destroy. There's happiness in sin for a season, but it will not last. What does the Bible say? It says in John.
Speak up.
I need a megaphone. Yeah. were all lost. We have all sinned. We don't have to continue in sin. It says in Romans 6, shall we continue in sin? No, we don't have to continue in sin. We get saved by grace, but through faith. We have to have faith that he has the power over any sin.
No, I'm sorry.
All right, you better back up. It's very dangerous. There was a man of the Pharisees named Nicodemus, the ruler of the Jews. This man came to Jesus by night and said to him, Rabbi, we know that you are a teacher, come from God, for no one can do these signs that you do unless God is with him. God did miracles when he came to earth. Jesus answered and said to him, most assuredly I say to you, unless one is born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God. How do we be born again? Shall we be reincarnated? No, that doesn't work. We don't get reincarnated. Once we lose this body, it's over. It's over. What about our spirits? Where do they go? That's being born again, because what you see, it's all gonna pass. All these things you see, it's gonna pass away. But the Word of God lives forever. What is faith? All right, let me read a little more.
Did you want me to hold your Bible? Oh, no, you're used.
So Jesus said, most assuredly I say to you, unless one is born of the water and the Spirit, he cannot enter the kingdom of God. That which is born of the flesh is flesh, and that which is born of the Spirit is spirit. Do not marvel that I say to you, you must be born again. The wind blows where it wishes, and you hear the sound of it, but cannot tell where it comes from or where it goes. So is everyone who is born of the Spirit. Everything you see is going to pass away. The Word of God will endure. What's he talking about, like the Spirit? How is the Spirit like wind? How many of you see wind? Are you seeing any wind? Where is it? Where is it? Where is the wind? This is what the wind looks like. Right here. See this? See this? Can you see this?
I don't think the wind looks like a Bible.
This is what the wind looks
like. I'm
pretty
sure that's just a Bible.
Do you see that? This is what the wind looks like.
How come it's blank?
You don't see it. You see it when it touches the trees. That's when you see the wind. But you don't see the wind, you see the results of the wind. And when the Holy Spirit comes in you, and he can forgive your sins, Jesus can forgive your sins. That's why he came to earth, because he loves you, and he wants you to know what life is really about.
Can you please go back in our
class? I am here because of you. Because we love you. We are concerned for you. Jesus said that he's come to give life, and this is what he did when he came to earth. He gave life. He gave physical life. He actually raised the dead.
Is that a coloring book?
He walked on water.
Is that a coloring
book? Wait, really?
He healed the sick.
Oh my God.
He healed the blind.
That's amazing.
And all these stories are in the Bible, if you just read the Bible. But you know what's even more amazing and even more miraculous?
Back it up.
You a whole new creation. You can have a new beginning right now. And once you have that feeling, this is the kind of life you will live. It is full. It is beautiful. It's full of life and color and beauty that you cannot
have.
You like that, huh? When I gave my life to you, Jesus at 15 years old, I was out in the field and I said, Jesus, I know that I'm a sinner, that I'm lost. I ask you to forgive me. The Jesus, please. I know that you are the Son of God, that you came to earth to die for my sins as God. And I repent. I want to give you my life. And that night, honest to God, the stars were just like polka dots before. When I gave my life to Jesus, they were sparkles. Everything changed, even physically, when I gave my life to Christ. Because he is the author of life. He is the beginning of living. He is not the end of life as you know it. Except in the past. I'm sorry, I do have asthma. I got it in here from all the dust. But
okay.
When you give your life to Jesus, you will find that it is so full and so abundant. No longer those things. I mean, what do you live for? What? Tell me, really, what can you live for? You can live for the world, which means what? Temporal things. Everything you see, again, as I said, will disappear. They will vanish. One of these days, even the Bible says the whole world will be destroyed with fire. But that's not coming.
We're at the University of Illinois.
On the earth.
You're listening to Sister Lori Tipton. Was a missionary in India for over 15 years. Was a missionary in Afghanistan with her husband in Romania, Pakistan. And she has a heart to win souls. So she's just with us for a few days to get some experience how to preach on the campuses. And then she's going to go back to Georgia and do it. She also still has a ministry in India and flies there. That was canceled this time because of COVID. But you might want to connect with her and support her ministry in India. But she's just given a powerful testimony here at the University of Illinois. And got the students' attention. In spite of COVID, we've got ministry going here, and we're thankful. Pray for CMUSA, Brother Chad and Company.